7654321.
It's Morning Kicks Extra with Randy and Jen.
It's the 126th episode of Morning Kicks Extra.
Woohoo! Extra means an extra dose of Randy and Jen.
And while that honestly might not seem like the best idea, it is a great way to catch up on stuff you might have missed out on during the show.
Or if there's anything you want to listen to again.
Like how you can shrink your brain by drinking too much.
And the first ever Florida games happened down in Florida.
And we'll be talking about the weirdest thing you've ever been bitten by.
Randy.
Doesn't sound good.
So let's get things kicked off.
On Morning Kicks Extra.
Morning Kicks Extra with Randy and Jen.
Police in Lakewood, Colorado, which is a suburb of Denver, they arrested a burglary suspect, again, on the toilet.
Okay, now the suspect was on the toilet, not the police, but boy, that would have been something, wouldn't it?
So it happened last Thursday morning. Police body cam video shows an officer throwing open a door and finding the suspect on the throne with his pants down around his ankles.
And the cop says, "Show me your hands."
And then the suspect says, "I'm on the," you know, rhymes with quitter. "Bro, I barely made it."
What word is that? Spitter?
You know, rhymes with
twister.
Twitter. Twister
litter?
Doesn't rhyme with quitter.
Kind of does.
No, it doesn't.
It kind of does.
Twister. Quitter.
It's got the I and the er.
Twitter.
So the suspect, who was not identified, was previously involved in a burglary.
Police noted that they see a lot of things in the line of duty. All right, officer, we're going to handle the jokes from here.
Wash those hands before I cup them.
You know, sometimes police work stinks.
Really does.
Jen's Movie Rehab.
So this is where we assign a different movie to Jen to watch over the weekend because...
Well, before I came to Kicks, I'd really never seen a lot of movies before, so someone would make a reference and I wouldn't get it.
She'd always squint her eyes shut real tight whenever one was on. And we're like, no, it's okay, you can watch them.
So every Friday, I get a movie assigned to me to watch over the weekend, and then I come back on Monday, rank it 1 to 10, let you know what I thought about it.
And here lately, we've been on kind of a Valentine's kick. It's been romance movies. We did Ghost, we did Top Gun, you know, the romance kind of action. This week is no different. We've got another romance for you to watch.
Ooh, okay.
It's a 1983 American romance directed by Brian De Palma and written by Oliver Stone, called Scarface.
Scarface.
Yeah, it's about the emotional scarring that a man goes through a relationship. It's a remake of originally a 1932 film and was based on a 1930s novel by Armitage Trail. Tells the story of Cuban refugee Tony Montana, who after getting a green card in exchange for, let's say he took out a Cuban government official, he stakes a claim in Miami, Florida.
This sounds not like a romance movie at all.
But it is, because he breaks through the barriers anybody stands in his way to get to his true love, becoming the biggest drug lord in the state, controlling nearly all the cocaine that comes through Miami. But pressure from police, wars with Colombian drug cartels, and his own drug-fueled paranoia serves to fuel the flames of his eventual downfall. You're going to love it.
What am I watching?
It's called Scarface. Are you not paying attention? Come on, Jen. Get on board here.
It's
definitely not a movie for the kids, okay? At the time that it came out, it was widely criticized for its violence.
Oh, is it really gory?
I don't know. But it's rated a strong R. You can watch it for free, though, in standard definition, but you're not going to get all the benefit of all the blood and everything that happens.
Oh, no. What a shame.
You can watch it on Tubi, standard def, or pay to stream it on most other platforms. Watch for the chainsaw scene.
I don't want to watch for the chainsaw scene.
You have to.
You talked about how awful it is.
Again, squinting your eyes during the movies is how you miss all these things, okay?
Okay.
So come back and give us a rating and review on Scarface on Monday.
For Jen's Movie Rehab.
Morning Kicks Extra with Randy and Jen.
There's this new study that suggests that drinking even as little as one beer or just a glass of wine every day is actually associated with a shrinkage in the brain volume equal to 2 years of aging.
One day. One beer.
One day. That's it.
2 years. Researchers, they studied the MRIs of some like 36,000 middle-aged adults and compared the scans with their reported alcohol intake.
So then they put them in these groups by average daily alcohol intake. So
I don't
want to
be in a group.
None to two beers or glasses of wine or more a day. And then the researchers found that the more alcohol consumed was associated with a more pronounced decline in brain volume, regardless of all the other factors.
So, I mean, sure, your brain shrinks as you get older. It's part of the whole process. But this says this could rapidly advance that. So what happened to drinking a glass of wine? It's good for your heart health and blah, blah, blah. Who are we to believe?
Your heart's going to be really healthy. Your brain's just going to be real dumb.
And ultimately, isn't that what it's all about?
I shrink my brain from getting drunk again, pouring liquor in.
My brain loses a small amount.
Stupider every day. With every drink I make.
Cause every little drink causes your brain to shrink. It's getting hard to think because I like to drink. I'm getting dumber with every red and white wine. I'm getting drunk and giving me a small mind.
Oh, dummy boy, drunken boy, brain destroyed.
I shrink my brain from getting drunk again. Pouring liquor in my mouth. I shrink my brain from getting drunk again. Brain matter is shrinking down. I shrink my brain from getting drunk again. Get away from the dead passing out. I shrink my brain from getting drunk again. My brain loses all amount.
Morning Kicks Extra with Randy and Jen.
Well, it looks like the all-you-can-eat buffets are maybe going to be a thing of the past.
No! No, say it isn't so!
So, Red Lobster, they recently shared that their all-you-can-eat, the big shrimp that they do, the offering, led to an $11 million loss. That's insane. $11 million.
Maybe that wasn't the best business model possible, but actually, there's a lot of restaurants that have come through and said all the all-you-can-eat meal specials that they run every so often is a huge, huge chunk out of their budget, and that they use it to bring in new customer base, but it hasn't been working as well as it has in the past. In fact, it's been manipulated by the customers to where only the people come that are going for that. So they're not making any profit off of this.
I mean, $11 million loss. Can you imagine having restaurants all over the U.S. and you still lose $11 million?
And trying to make that up?
Well, they're saying now that the all-you-can-eat thing could become a thing of the past as part of the business model because it's just not being successful anymore.
Well, you know, the buffets aren't going to apologize for that, unfortunately.
Yep. Yeah. So luckily, we've got Mr. Morgan Freeman to do it for them.
Hello. I am all you can eat. Whether it's a local buffet or endless shrimp at a chain restaurant, I'd like to sincerely apologize for bringing them all to the brink of bankruptcy. I'm sorry that some Americans treat all you can eat as a challenge to behave like Joey Chestnut on the 4th of July.
Tell me I can't.
But instead of being the hot dog eating champ, your prize is putting a place like Red Lobster in the red. I regret that all you can eat may soon become a thing of the past, and that you'll be forced to take human-sized bites and not go back for 14ths. Apologetically yours, all you can eat.
Morning Kicks Extra.
So there is this massive class action lawsuit that's going on against Amazon Prime, their video service, because they have started playing ads in their video content unless you give them more money.
Which is ridiculous because what you were paying for didn't have ads before and now there's suddenly ads in there. That's not what we signed up for.
They're saying they're in breach of contract because of this, that they went and changed the rules without first getting your agreement on this.
So a lot of people are trying to cancel Prime, but it's really not an easy thing to do.
Oh, no. They've got a multi-step, multi-layer process that they're making you go through. And in defense of this behavior, Amazon founder and evil genius Jeff Bezos had this to say.
Greetings. It's Amazon CEO Jeff Bezos here. My subordinates have informed me that users are having a difficult time canceling Amazon Prime. But if you really must cancel, it's really simple, with only 6 easy steps. I won't be angry. It's not like I'm going to slowly dip you into hot magma. What am I saying? Just pay the frickin' $15 to my evil corporation, Amazon, which is on its way to making trillions. Or even better, billions.
Morning Kicks Extra.
Guess what happened over the weekend?
What happened over the weekend?
The first Florida Man game.
So a dozen teams battled in contests that were inspired by these real events from America's Sunshine State. The games kicked off with the Star Spangled Banner, of course, played on electric guitar.
As it should have been.
And then spectators were cheering on the contestants in different contests like an eating contest, which involved a plate loaded with barbecue pork and sausage. There was fighting in muddy water in an inflatable pool. They were trying to, like, pummel each other with weapons made from pool noodles and duct tape, of course. There was a theft simulation relay in which competitors had to race while carrying a pair of bicycles, copper pipes, and catalytic converters. What does that tell you about Florida?
I don't know, but my favorite event was the wrestling that they did sumo style while holding pitchers of beer.
Which just seems so Florida to me. Don't spill the beer.
Running from actual sheriff's deputies while jumping fences and avoiding obstacles. These were real events. I'm not making this up.
What about the one when they were trying to grab the cash that was flying around in the simulated hurricane winds? That one's pretty good, too.
So they had about 5,000 spectators come to this. They each paid about $45 to watch the games. And even though being Florida, you could have seen that kind of stuff for free on any given newscast.
So did the residents or the contestants have to actually verify that they lived there in Florida?
I don't think so. I believe that if you want to compete, it was just assumed that you were from Florida.
You know, it doesn't really feel complete without like an alligator showing up and lunging at people.
By the way, the winners did get a prize. The losers got a bus ticket out of the state because they did not measure up.
I think next year they need to have a hit your partner in the face with a food item contest, because I feel like there has
been a lot of that.
Right?
Well, this was the theme song for this year's event.
Who puts alligator?
Who puts alligator?
Into garbage cans.
Into garbage cans.
Steals a rack of ribs by stashing it inside his pants. Florida man.
Florida man.
Oh, the Florida man can.
Florida man.
Florida man can, cause he's really freaking high from all the drugs he took.
All the drugs he took. Florida man fails, all the way goes to jail, and Hooters he gets arrested.
Charged with bitten all possession, passed out at an intersection.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Who's blocking the highway?
Who's blocking the highway?
Running in the nude.
Running in the nude.
Got caught shaving all the hair off of a monkey at the zoo. Florida man.
Florida man.
Oh, the Florida man can.
Florida man can.
Florida man can, cause he snorts bath salts and scares the neighbor.
It's Morning Kicks Extra with Randy and Jen.
We're talking today about the weirdest thing you've ever been bitten by. My little brother, there was a beetle. I forget what kind of beetle it is, but they've got these caliper pinchers on the front. He got one of those, pinched his tongue, and we couldn't get it to let go.
Wait, how did it get so close to his tongue?
That's a question, isn't it? He never would say or admit to anything weird, but my dad finally got the wise idea to stick a lighter under the beetle, and that did make it let go finally, but it was like an hour before we were able to get that done.
Oh, his poor tongue.
And then that time, it left almost pierced his tongue.
What's the craziest thing that you've ever been bit by?
A horny toad.
A what?
Uncle Larry?
No, I was in Phoenix my whole life as a kid, and we had horny toads. They're like little toads that have horns on the back of their head.
Right.
And, oh yeah, I used to mess with them all the time, and I had a bug, and I was trying to feed it. Yeah, it got my fingers.
Well, technically, that would have been feeding it too. I mean... What's the weirdest thing that you've ever been bitten by?
Well, it wasn't that bit me. It was my brother.
What happened?
We lived down in Dallas, and he worked at a place called Lion Country Safari.
Yeah.
And he's working the gate, and this thing comes up out of the ditch, latches onto his boot. Come to find out, it's called a Nutra.
A Nutra?
Actually, I think it's called a Nutria, isn't it?
Looks like a giant rat. It's got orange teeth. Bit on his boot, and the warden had to come down there and shoot it.
Man, Nutria.
What is the craziest thing you've ever been bit by?
Actually, it was a horse, and I know that doesn't sound like it's all that.
Whoa, wait a minute. Did you say, you said you got bit by a what?
Horse.
Oh, a horse, a pony.
Randy.
Well, I thought those were some really angry women.
You knew what she was.
She had just given birth, and I had walked up to her feeding her, and the baby came up next to her, and she bit me. It's just where she bit me.
Where'd she bite you?
Right between my breasts.
No, ow.
And I was still in high school time, and it was so bad that I couldn't have anything touching it, so I had to wear low-cut glasses, and everybody called it a horse hickey.
A horse hickey. You know, I've heard that term before, but it was while I was in the military, and it meant something totally different.
It's Morning Kids Extra with Randy and Jen.
We're talking today about the weirdest thing that you've ever been bit by.
Did you know the geese bite?
Oh, yeah, they do. Are you just now finding this out?
No, when I was little, we were feeding the geese out, and my sister got bit right on the butt.
You want to go to the park later today?
Nope. Those geese are mean.
What's the weirdest thing you've ever been bitten by?
A bluegill on my eyelid.
Your eyelid?
Why would you have a perch up near your eyelid?
I was tanning on a dock, and my hair was hanging over the edge, and a bluegill were just playing in my hair, and all of a sudden, one jumped up and just bit me on my eyelid. I had a purple welt for 2 days.
Oh, well, my gosh.
That's a different way to catch a fish, isn't it?
That's exactly right. Exactly right.
And then you had fried fish for dinner.
I think there's something fishy with this whole story.
Very fishy. Very fishy indeed.
What's the weirdest thing that you've ever been bit by?
I got bit by a squirrel.
A squirrel? How?
A squirrel. I caught one with my bare hand.
Why is the big question here?
Was he unconscious?
I was just a young kid playing around a tree and snuck up on the squirrel and grabbed him by the tail, and it was like fighting a buzzsaw.
What's the craziest thing you've ever been bit by?
Black snake.
How'd that happen?
I won't say that alcohol was involved, but I won't say that it was neither.
So let me get this straight. You took a black snake out, got it drunk, and then forced it to bite you? Is that what he's saying?
No, I don't think that's what he's saying at all.
Alcohol's involved.
What's the craziest thing you've ever been bit by?
My wife.
Yeah, you shouldn't have gotten that close to her while she was trying to eat.
It's Morning Kicks Extra with Randy and Jen.
We're talking about the craziest thing you've ever been bitten by.
Hi there, Morning Kicks.
A walleye.
A walleye fish?
Oh, my, yes.
Why did you poke your finger in the fish's mouth?
Well, you know, I would get the hook out. I always stick my thumb in there and grab a hold of it so I can get a better leverage and get the hook out. And I didn't realize they had teeth, and it clamped down on my thumb. And holy cow.
They do have a lot of teeth.
What's the craziest thing you've ever been bit by?
A prairie dog and a monkey.
What?
On the same day?
Yeah, I own both of them.
What? Wait a minute. Explain this to us.
Yeah, backstory.
Well, I bought a prairie dog from Petland down there in Joplin.
They sell prairie dogs?
What?
Yeah, I bought a prairie dog from Petland there on 7th Street as a pet for my daughter. And I went in to feed him and took him out of the cage, and I guess I squeezed him too hard because he bit. I own 4 different monkeys.
So on the same day. You know what? It may be time for you to go to work for the zoo, my man.
My house is like a zoo. I've got tarantulas, monkeys, prairie dogs, lizards.
Feeding time's at 4 p.m., Randy.
Yeah, they all eat at the same time, whatever we're eating.
Wait a minute. Are you letting me know so that I can get in line or what?
Well, yeah, of course.
What's the weirdest thing that you've ever been bit by?
The strangest thing I've ever been bit by would have to be an emu.
An emu.
Oh, my gosh. Those things that look like an ostrich, right?
Yeah. We used to have an emu farm at our house. We had about 20 pairs of emu. I went out to feed them, and one came up behind me and bit me right on the back of the head.
Eat your food, Tina.
Yeah. You know, the daughter bites the hand that feeds you. Well, it bit the back of the head of the person who feeds them.
What's the craziest thing you've ever been bit by?
My husband.
You're going to need shots now, Fran.
I know. And he didn't even have his teeth in at the time.
I don't even want to know where he bit you. I think that's called a nom-nom.
Nom-nom.
Okay. What is the craziest thing you've ever been bit by?
Well, believe it or not, I got bit by a ladybug one time.
A ladybug?
What, ladybugs bite?
Yeah, I actually Googled it, and yeah, they can bite. I guess it's very common.
Did it hurt?
Yeah, it was kind of like just a small sting. Kind of caught me off guard because I wasn't expecting it.
Well, who is?
You know? Right here, bite me.
Well, that's not fair. I mean, you say that to everyone.
I guess, needless to say, it didn't live through the attack, so.
No one does with Jen either. No, you don't live through those attacks.
What's the craziest thing you've ever been bit by?
She doesn't smack you down, the infection will get you.
Randy, I don't...
It's Morning Kicks Extra with Randy and Jen.
Hey, join us on the next edition of Morning Kicks Extra.
We're going to be talking about the job perk where you work.
I bet if you look hard enough, you can find one.
In the meantime, don't forget to check out our blog at kicks1025.com.
You can check out all of the latest Morning Kicks karaoke songs.
And you can watch us live on most social platforms every weekday morning starting at 7.
Make sure to like, follow, and smash that subscribe button.
Bonk! Don't miss Morning Kicks with Randy and Jen. Weekday mornings from 6 to 10 on the 4 states' #1 for country, Kicks 102.5.